Congrats, you two. You defended your title. Linz must feel like some home tournament to you now. Yeah, how did that feel, the victory?
Yeah, it feels really good, like coming back after winning last year the title here together and then win it again. I think that's something that we never did. So yeah, I'm really happy with this victory again.
They put up on the big screen like a couple of photos of you and with the hashtag Team Yoki. Is Team Yoki like establishing as a hashtag like similar to Team Gucci, for example? Is that now?
Yeah, I think we used it for quite a while, and somehow it's sticking a little bit. I think it's fun with a little bit different hashtag names, and you have, for example, the Australian team also ABCD.
Yeah,
I think that's quite a good one as well. So yeah, we have to keep using.
Well, we've been trying to do some quick math. But it seems like you're very, very close to a flight to Singapore. How does that feel?
Yeah, that feels unbelievable. I think we won the first tournament of the year in Auckland, and then we said like afterwards, yeah, let's go for Singapore now. I don't know if that was like really serious or not, but yeah, now we played some good weeks in the last few, or in the whole year, I think, but especially now, and yeah, we have a really big chance, so yeah, hopefully we can make it, but we will see in Luxembourg.
It's the 10th title together, so it's starting to be a very...
Nine.
Also, there is an ITF, here, so...
Ah, okay, yeah, that's true. Yeah.
It's going to be a very big and stable couple. What's next goals in Singapore apart, of course? Are you thinking about Slams, thinking about something big now?
Yeah, I mean, I think we played quite a few years and we're getting better and better and stronger as a team out there. And the more matches we play, we also learn more about each other. And we've been to two quarterfinals in the Grand Slam, and the next one will be semis and final, of course. But right now, I think we focus on Singapore and try and reach there, and that will be a huge experience as well. And then we see for next year what's going to happen.
What do you like about each other's personality? Why does that fit so well on the court?
Yeah, I don't know. No, it's just like, also off the court, we go along really well, like going for dinner or just have a talk or just having fun. And I think that makes it like much more easier. We travel so many weeks, and then if you sometimes you're really struggling in the singles and that's a little bit more stress, but then out there in doubles it's really fun, and I think we can relax a little bit more, and I think we're always fighting, so that's what I really like about Jo. Like even if you're down, then she's really trying to push you, and yeah, I think that's also what I need. Yeah.
Joanna?
Yeah, definitely. I think Kiki is usually positive, but sometimes she gets very irritated, and then I can be there and support her, and I have a big temper as well, and I get more like angry and frustrated, and then Kiki can be there to calm me down, and so I think we are using our good and bad quite well out there.
We can calm each other down, but not ourselves, so I think that's a good thing. Yeah.
And push each other.
Yeah, and push each other.
We had Mats Wilander here at the tournament, and he did the on-court interview after your victory. How was that for you, since he's Swedish, and you would be also the first Swedish at all to qualify for the finals at the end of the year? Another aspect.
Swedish woman. Yeah, that would be amazing, of course. But it's always, you know, it's always so much talk about it, and we're not really there yet, so you never want to jump too soon. But we have we put some pressure, and we see how far that gets us, and let's talk after Luxembourg.
Yeah. And was it any special to you that Mats was here?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he's a huge name in Sweden, and I met him a few times out on the tournaments, and he's commentating a lot, so I see him every now and then. But of course, when you get to talk a little bit, it's always special.
And another question to Kiki: like the tournaments that are organized by Sandra, they seem to do quite well. You won Nuremberg already twice. What makes those tournaments special to you?
Well, I think the people who are organizing it is really, they're really friendly, really nice. They try to do everything for you. So I always feel like, yeah, really comfortable going to this tournament. Also Nuremberg, like there, it feels great. And here it's the same again. And okay, of course, it's a great feeling if you won a tournament once to go back. But then even get another victory, yeah, I think it's even better and makes it even better to come back again.
That's why I play with her this tournament. Yeah. I'm smart. I'm making good partner.
Even for fitness, for clay court skills especially, but you've been doing very well indoor twice, winning this, did well the past few weeks. Why?
Well, I think for the doubles, I think we also played really, really well on the hard courts. Of course, especially in the singles, we prefer both more than clay. But in the singles, that makes it a little bit easier. I think in the doubles, we try to play quicker also on the clay. And on the hard courts, it's, I think, not really a big difference. And yeah, I think it suits our game also here.
Yeah, and I actually think both of us is really good on the clay, but we're getting much better on the hard court.
Yeah.
And especially for myself, yeah. I actually really like to play indoor now. And these courts here is very slow to be indoor. So that is helping also. If you have a little bit bigger swings or something like that, you still have some time. And that's good for both of us.
If you were saying you would drive to Luxembourg and there would be a lot of singing in the car.
Let's see.
Yeah, maybe.
She can sing, I can listen. I can't sing.
She's the one to sing.
Yeah, definitely.
What kind of songs?
I don't know. We just put the phone, I think, on the shuffle, and then we see. I think there's a lot of bad songs are coming, so we see. Yeah.
And which is your favorite song?
I don't know.
Oh, favorite song? That's tough. Now You is a good one.
Yeah.
You can Google that one.
Yeah.
If there's no more tennis questions, it's a bit different topic, but in February there's the Winter Olympics, and well, both countries are good in winter sports. First question is, will you follow, or do you follow any winter sports?
Always. I mean, I always follow all the sports and national sports like that, so of course, I think it's really fun, and Sweden will have a competition against Holland, of course, but
well, I think
so
we are in different sports. So,
they are so good in the ice skating, they take every medal there, so it's not fair.
And we don't have anyone in the skiing.
That's
what you're doing, so yeah.
Nah, we see. Yeah. It's always fun with different sports, and seeing as we both went to Olympics now for last summer, it's also a little bit more special to watch it now.
You understand it a little bit more how things are going. Yeah.
And then, if you could compete at the Winter Olympics, in which sport would it be?
None.
Well, you have best chance for the
yeah.
I think I would go cross-country skiing. I really like that. I did it a lot when I was younger, and that's, I think, typical Swedish sport.
Yeah. Well, I have to, well, the only sport we're good in, I think, in the Winter Olympics is like the speed skating, but it's a really long time that I did that, so I think I have to practice a little bit more now. Yeah.
What are your plans for the off season?
Yeah, well, I thought first it was already like finished. The season was finished after Luxembourg, so now maybe we have another week. And yeah, then first it's time for holiday, and then yeah, make a good plan and schedule again what we're gonna do for next year.
But you were interested in the holiday plans as well.
I think Singapore makes it also a little bit different now, maybe. Maybe then hang around there, close there. I don't know yet. We still need to talk about it.
What about you?
I have no plans. I'm free falling.
Oh, and since we have also fans watching, last time they asked what were your like weirdest presents by fans you got so far? Or maybe also the cutest presents you got? Or that people said to you, maybe fans said to you?
Well, it's always nice to get things from the fans. I think that's why you're doing your play also for them, and it's really nice if you get some stuff, but I cannot come up with something now. I don't know
either. I think the trophy I won once in Båstad with the swine was quite fun. Yeah. That was a little bit unexpected, but a nice trophy. But the present from fans, and I don't know either.
No. But here you got a present, like a gin?
Yeah, well, last year was, I think, a little bit of a joke. Last year we got like this huge bottle of gin on court, and maybe Sandra had some problems with that, I don't know. But so right now we got trophies, and we were like, where's the gin? So, and then afterwards she came up with the bottle, so yeah. So that's why. And we both even don't like gin, so. But it was more about like the battle and everything last year, yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much, and good luck for Luxembourg and then probably the WTA finals.
Thanks.